我来电视网在今天非常开心访问到是达拉斯独行侠的 Josh Green 啊 ，Hello Josh。
Hi, how you doing?
First, we're from Taiwan. Would you like to say something to your Taiwan fans here?
Yeah, of course. I mean, I appreciate all the support from Taiwan, you know, from the Asian district in Australia. So it's exciting to see how big basketball is over there.
It feels like a roller coaster game last night. And what do you think about the final series now?
It's been amazing. You know, it's been everything I dreamed of, you know, apart, you know.I think it's been competitive, and it's been a, you know, it's been a great experience. You know, we still got more games left, and I'm super excited.
So let's talk about your NBA career. What has been the most significant adjustment you have to make since you joined NBA?
I think just finding, you know, your role and how you can help out a team. You know, I think it varies for every single team. You know, there's a lot of amazing players in the league, and it's figuring out, you know, what's going to keep you on the court and.What's gonna, you know, help you and help the team out in general. You know, I think it's finding that. So I think that can be difficult for anyone.
And talk about Luka Doncic. How has playing alongside with Luka Doncic influenced your development as a player?
I think he's, you know, he's done an amazing job, you know, being able to learn from him. You know, he's a very, very smart player. So just being able to learn different reads and whatnot from him has been great.
And what aspect of your game are you focusing on improving the, in this season, most of the season?
This season? Just, you know, really just buying into, you know, what, you know, my role is for this year and just making sure that I'm doing whatever I can for the team to win, bringing energy. So I think that's what I've really been focusing on is just making, like, just doing whatever I can for the team to win.
And can you describe your relationship with Coach Jason Kidd and how he helped you now?
I have a great relationship with Coach Kidd. You know, I don't think I'd be in this situation without him. So, you know, coming into my second year into the NBA, I really didn't play my rookie year. So, you know, him giving me the opportunity was, you know, it was amazing. And I really appreciate it. And I think just being able to have the player-coach relationship like what, you know, everyone on the team has is it's really important as a player because you know, he sees both sides of the, of everything. Sorry.
That's great. And how do you stay mentally and physically prepared for the long NBA season?
Yeah, I mean, it's been a very long season. You know, I started the World Cup like probably nearly a year ago today. So it's been a long season. But I think, you know, just being able to find stuff that you enjoy outside of basketball, too. And then obviously, you know, having my family here now has been amazing. You know, my little sister being able to see me do this, you know, hopefully I can, you know, motivate her to be here. Younger brother, same.So I think, you know, just there's always joys in it, you know, and at the end of the day, you know, I'm super grateful to be able to just play basketball as my sport.
And what is your favorite memory or moment from your time with the Mavericks so far?
Favorite moment? It's got to be now. I mean, I think it's so hard to always, you know, we always look in the past and we always look in the future. But like, you know, sometimes the present is, you know, the best time. And, you know, I think that's, you know, sometimes I struggle on that. You know, I always look in the future or I look in the past and dwell on things. But, you know, we're in a very exciting time and we've, you know, achieved something that's is really big for an NBA player.
还要提醒大家 ，Josh Green 的专访，我们还有下集，请大家敬请期待。那除了场上的球员之外，我们也要关心一下场边在主播台上的球员，像是吉文毕就担任嘉宾，跟 Paul George 一起聊天打趣。
但是和这些零冠仔相比，隔壁棚四冠在手的四神汤 Klay Thompson 可就没有心情跟大家嘻嘻哈哈啦。除了续约谈不拢以外，最近还被发现他取消追踪勇士的社群账号，引发不小讨论。
NBA 总冠军赛打得精彩，场边播报台上的亮点也不少，特别请来了联盟零冠代表 Paul George 跟 Joel Embiid， 但可别以为他们就只是光鲜亮丽的到台上打打嘴炮就可以领钱啦、啊！两位大哥心里肯定也是百感交集，毕竟这可都是他们总冠军赛的初登板。
I mean, this is my first final appearance, and I hate that it had to come in this fashion. You know what I mean? Watching from the sideline, it don't feel good. You know, shout out to the two teams that made it this far, but when you think back of what we should have done and could have done better to be where they're at right now, all of the little plays, you know, you start to think about.
人帅又会自嘲 ，Podcast 主持功力又有两把刷子，只能说 PG 我欣赏你。而相形之下，今年赛季卫冕 MVP 失败，球队又提早打包去中南美洲小岛度假的球 MB， 是完全没在管什么播报伦理啦，带着鲜明的立场开始大谈，同时也在灰色地带展开他的补强招募计划。
And I hate Boston. You know, great city, great fans. You know, obviously they got some great players, but he hurts me a lot. So hopefully, you know, this offseason we find a way to get better and, you know, add some pieces. And yeah, so
add some pieces. Okay.
哇塞，这有点明目张胆了吧？而且这个时机只能说是恰到好处。毕竟七六人今年夏天 ，Tobias Harris 毕竟4000万的年薪合约即将结束。届时会有不小空间进行补强，然后久久眉来眼去的 Paul George， 下个赛季则是球员选项。在快艇不愿意开出顶薪留人的情况下，还真的有不小想象空间。但相比于在播报台上的林冠仔们嘻嘻哈哈有说有笑，谈钱终究是伤感情。毕竟格一鹏四冠在手的四爷Klay Thompson 最近跟球团的关系可是有点尴尬，被发现在社群平台上取消追踪勇士队，并且删除2022年夺冠和科瑞的合照。难道说这就是暴风雨前的宁静吗？
They was talking about it. They had a video saying I unfollowed the Warriors, but I didn't follow them in the first place. I didn't follow them all year. So you know, you just go to it at a certain time and you see it and it fits the storyline. So you know, you got to be careful when the media playing with situations.
Yeah, you can't trust us at all.
Moody 说的有理，但也是过度保守。毕竟 Klay 目前的困境在于，同为四冠老臣的 Curry 续约价码是4年2.15亿美金。而动不动就打人惹事的嘴绿也有4年1亿美金的价码，人家四神汤再怎么说也期望一份旗鼓相当的元老合约。但坏就坏在勇士实在不想缴跟上个赛季一样高达1亿7000万，相当于54亿台币的豪华税。倘若球团硬着头皮以嘴绿的价码留住四爷，那将会只剩下1000万美金的空间进行补强，极有可能再度以不上不下的阵容浪费 Curry 宝贵的巅峰时间。而 NBA 自由市场预计将于7月3号正式开启，外界预测 Klay 的潜在下家魔术、七六人还有活塞都正准备祭出银弹攻势，再加上现在这个节骨眼他大哥退追球团的行为，都让这四神汤人生后续走向更加扑朔迷离。
好，接着镜头回到台湾，就在 NBA 总冠军赛第四战进行之际，未来团队也前进台南成大举办本年度第6场的直播派对。而除了有不少球迷共襄盛举以外，还有一位最近讨论热度也不低的直篮球员也到场，马上来看看现场画面。
NBA 季后赛正如火如荼开打当中，总冠军赛来到 Game 4。今天我们的直播派对呢，是来到了台南的成功大学来举行。可以看到篮球热潮是风靡全台，球迷们 ，NBA 季后赛要看哪一台？
未来体育台。
球迷们说的完全没有错 ，NBA 精彩赛事绝对要锁定最爱篮球的未来。这季我们一共举办了6场直播派对，其中4场集中在季后赛期间，引起广大回响。而这次来到南台湾的成大校园，学生球迷一样超热情，
我觉得气氛很棒啊，因为我们知道那个微秀也有这种，就用大荧幕来看球的一个活动，然后我不知道像成大也有办法这样看到。平常都在实验室用小荧幕看，现在可以看到这个 Mavs in 7， Let's go Mavs！
我是谁？我是谁？
可以分享一下原因吗？
我觉得他的团就是很特殊，乐于分享球，不贪功啊。好 ，Game 6，
明年吧，明年。再说一次，大逆转 ，OK， 大逆转。
看来这位球迷力挺 Kyrie Irving 是没有失望啦，独行侠最后在第4战击败塞尔提克，成功续命追到1-3。但这场直播派对的重点可不止看球而已，现场还抽出满满的礼品，连直篮球星也来共襄盛举。
自己是第一次参加这种活动，那自己也是很开心，可以就是到现场，然后跟学生他们一起来看比赛。平常的时候也是会看 NBA， 那就是学习就是 NBA 他们在场上一些不管是技术啊，还是一些球技上的一些特点，应该都看 Holiday 的防守。
球迷们看球赛看得过瘾，抽奖也拿得开心，球星合照当然也没问题，一个早上下来可说是尽兴而归。荧幕机前的你要是也想要这满满福利，下次直播派对千万别错过。